I was able to unlock another room in the main living area.
Good to know. I'll check it out when I can.
That's the warden function.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
The door's unlocked now. Gaia, what was this room for?
This was intended to be a recreational room for control center operatives. Unfortunately, the entertainment modules were lost with the Apollo database.
Oh, that's too bad.
Switch to a private log? Okay, so, Regional Control Center 9. Design of the facilities coming along? When Gaia finally builds it, it'll have everything it needs. Except personality. So, I'm going to sneak in my own mark. A couple of flourishes. Starting with this little tucked away hideout. August would have gotten a kick out of it. He loved hidden passages. Like the kind in old English castles. But I've got something bigger planned. My piece de resistance, if you will.
Another room? What for? Oh, I'm back in the sleeping quarters. Looks like Arendt and Catalo moved their stuff in.
There it is.
Holograms. Gaia, I thought you said the data here was lost.
I was able to repurpose the equipment to store the data you have acquired in your travels.
Looks like someone's made this space their own.
I see you found Varl and Zoe's room, Aloy. I believe they wanted private accommodations.
I see.
There she is. You ready to head out?
Let's go.
Look at us. Three battle-hardened badasses forging into the unknown. This ought to be good. This distress call had to be up a really steep mountain, huh? Takes the keg.
Ugh. Burl, see if there's anything over there.
On it.
We'll check out the battlefield. Let's start with that zenith. Well, there are obviously more zeniths than we know about.
Can't believe you fought one of them.
Almost didn't make it. I wonder how much snow is gonna pile up. Whatever the rebels did, it took down her shield. But why was she here? I can access her last communication file, but I'll use my focus to scan the battlefield too.
What about that crazy weapon the Zenith had?
It looked like she can make it come and go at will. But it's gone now.
Yeah. Well, go do your thing. I'll wait here.
What? What?
Hello, Verbena. What do you have for me?
I checked everywhere, still no sign of the asset. Can we call off this pointless search already?
Let's not forget who let it slip away in the first place. Now, I'd like to see results by nightfall. Do you think you can manage that?
Hold on. I think I see something.
The Spectre had instructions to assist recovery of the asset. I wonder what this asset is.
Forge's breath. What a mess. You done looking around?
Almost. Osserum with a focus. Looks like he was sending data on the weapons somewhere else. The weapon's still hot. I need to know how it worked. But I'll have to check on it once it's cooled off. Gather these while I can. Looks like the rebels camped here for a while. Are they watching this area? All right. I think I have an idea what happened here. I better get back to Erend.
All right, she who sees the unseen. What did you find out?
This was a carefully planned attack. I found camping gear up there. The rebels must have been staking out this place for at least a few days. They were waiting for the Zeniths to show up. All so that they could test that weapon. The Zeniths have a personal shield that makes them invulnerable, but somehow the weapon got rid of it. The Osserum that was operating it was sending data on it somewhere else. It was probably just a prototype.
I've known tinkers that do that. I'd do a little trial run before breaking out the real thing. Well, I guess it's still a work in progress, if it blew up.
She was searching for something she lost. Her drone had instructions to recover something called the asset.
The asset? Is that the sub-function thing that you said could be here? Eleuthia?
I'm not sure. Come on, let's go talk to Varl. That's a long way down.
Something tunneled straight down into the mountain. Looks recent.
Whatever it was, it must have been powerful. That Zenith the rebels killed was looking for something called the Asset. I don't know what it is, but my guess is it's somewhere down there.
All right, so we head down.
Erend, stay here and stand watch. That Zenith isn't the only one of its kind. I don't want to be caught by surprise if the others show up. Contact us by focus if you see anything.
Okay. Any trouble shows up, I'll call you.
Let's go. There's some kind of old world ruin down here.
You said the Zeniths have their own backup of Gaia, right?
Yeah, from the Proving Lab.
So maybe they were after Aluthia. Found its hiding spot, so it sent the distress signal.
Maybe. Looks like some kind of data center. I might be able to access the facility systems from that console. This was a Far Zenith research lab. Looks like a lot of data was beamcast from here recently. From that device nearby.
So Aluthia's gone?
If it was ever here, then probably. But then why were the Zeniths still searching for it, the asset? Let's keep looking around. I've never seen a transmitter like this before. Looks like it's self-destructed.
Another Far Zenith ruin.
At least this one doesn't seem to have giant killer machines.
Or anything you can blow up. Find anything that might tell us what the asset is?
I don't think so. Some kind of storage room, maybe.
Maybe the asset is in here somewhere.
If it is, somehow the Zenith couldn't find it. Let's look around. So, how is Erend taking all of this? Really?
Well, Gaia, the Zeniths, the focus, it's a lot. But when I caught up to him in the Daunt and said you needed our help, he dropped everything and turned around.
Well, he's loyal. That's for sure. A control console to access the storage units.
Can it tell us if the asset is in one of them?
Well, let's find out. Bag's full. I can get it from my stash later.
Six containers in storage. Please enter the container number you'd like to retrieve.
236? Wasn't there a number in the distress signal?
You're right. I should check the log.
Six containers in storage.
Skin's like ice. Must have cut this from her head. But why?
Hello, Elizabeth. Apologies, I don't know what else to call you. My name is Beta. I'm afraid I must be brief. I only have a few minutes before my keepers discover I'm missing, and I still need to remove this implant. I had hoped to find shelter with you, but if you're viewing this, I may be dead. Be careful when you take on Farsiness. They are ruthless, and they have Aluthea, Artemis, and Apollo now. But at least I don't have the Gaia Colonel to merge them with. You must succeed. Oh, this was all for nothing. Good luck. And goodbye.
So she's...
She's still alive.
We need to get her back to...
Oh, shit, they can fly. Aloy. Aloy, can you hear me through this thing?
What's going on, Erend?
Two of those Spectre things just fell out of the sky. One of them is heading down towards you. The other one's waiting up here.
We're coming up. Stay in cover until I get there.
You got it.
Get her to cover in that room. Whatever happens, she stays with us.
I'll protect her.
I should prepare before the Spectre gets here. I can't let it get through to Varl and the clone. It's clear for now. Here it comes! Ooh, ugly one, aren't you? I should scan that thing. See if it has any weak stuff. Things quick. I'm heading up top. Stay down here with the clone for now.
Got it. I'll follow once the coast is clear.
Gotta get back up top and deal with that other Spectre. I just hope Aaron stays in cover.
Seals in. It's got me pinned down.
Hang tight. I'm almost there.
Just hurry.
Oh, that doesn't sound good. I gotta get to Erend. Erend, I'm here.
Watch out. That thing shoots down the center.
Stay put. I'll see what I can do.
The second you need me, I'm there.
Spectre's not budging from that spot. I might be able to sneak up on it if I stay out of its line of fire. It's got some kind of shield. I'll sneak around behind it. Don't play it. Leave it alone.
Aloy, she's... Look, I swear I'm not drunk, but right now I'm seeing double.
Long story, but it'll have to wait.
She needs a healer, but we need to get her back to the base immediately.
Right. Yeah. Well, what are we waiting for then?
You two go on ahead. I need to take another look at that weapon. If I can figure out how that thing works, maybe the Zeniths won't be so invincible after all. I need to get the weapon fragment to Gaia to analyze. If we can replicate it, maybe we'll have a way to defeat the Zeniths. I should check on the clone, too. Varl, where's our guest?
We're in the maintenance corridor below the control room.
Okay. Where'd Cataldo go?
Is your focus acting up again?
It's fine. I just flick it a few times with my thumb.
Aloy, you're back.
Yeah, I'm just, checking up on how everyone's doing.
You mean after meeting someone who looks exactly like you, but isn't you? Down in the basement. Guess this must be even stranger for you than it is for us, huh?
A little.
Varl said she may be able to help us in our mission, though.
Maybe. What else have you been up to?
I've been studying Gaia's seedlings, the subfunctions. I wanted to understand why one of them would do what they did to Fa. Imagine my surprise when I looked into this Hephaestus. And found out it helped create all machines, our land gods included. In a way, the Utaru owe Hephaestus our whole way of life, as well as our current troubles.
That's why we have to make Gaia whole again. Learn anything interesting lately?
There's been much to read up on now that Aether has been reunited with Gaia. It's hard to imagine that machines like Stormbirds once helped heal the skies. I used to be terrified of them as a child. Thunder still brings chills to my skin. But everything Gaia creates has a purpose, no?
Yeah. And if we can get Hephaestus back, she can get those Stormbirds in line. You said you met Beta?
Varl mentioned she was hurt. I thought I'd offer her an extract to soothe the pain.
That was kind of you.
I just hope she doesn't plan on staying burrowed down there like that. She looks like she's barely seen the light of day as it is.
I need to get going.
May the land bloom in your steps.
Erend? You okay?
Huh? Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, why wouldn't I be?
Because there's two of me now.
Hey, there's two of you now! At least you seem to be handling it okay.
I wouldn't say that exactly, but I'm trying. What are you reading next?
I saw Gaia added something to the archives about metal rods being used to harness lightning during storms. The guy reminded me of a cousin of mine. Thought he could trap lightning if he covered himself in Stormbird plates. Went up the tallest mountain in the claim to prove it. It ended like a lot of Oseram things do. With a spark and a boom.
What are you working on with your focus?
I'm still figuring out how to read stuff on this thing. Those two lovebirds over there have been giving me a hand. But to be honest, all the little symbols, they give me a headache. But I'll get up to speed, I promise.
Did you speak with Beta at all?
She didn't really wake up till we brought her here. And when she did, I thought it'd be better if Zoe and Varl took care of her. No use crowding someone when they're in a state.
I have to get going.
Don't go causing too much trouble.
Aloy, glad you made it back okay. She panicked after waking up and stumbled down here. I thought it best to wait for you.
I'll talk to her. Hello? It's Beta, right? My name's Aloy. What's wrong? Is it your injury?
Simulacrum withdrawal syndrome.
I don't understand.
Sudden removal of a neurologically integrated data device. The brain, especially the cerebellum, goes into a kind of sensory freefall. Everything real feels unreal. Distant.
Is there anything that can help?
Do you have a focus to spare? It's primitive, but I can make it work.
Yeah.
Booting up.
So, Aloy, I suppose you want information. About you and the Zeniths?
Yeah.
Why are they here? What do they want? How did they get you? But let's start at the beginning. I'm guessing they faked the destruction of their ship 1,000 years ago?
That seems consistent with their behavior. They wouldn't want to be followed.
So Far Zenith established a colony world after all.
Yes, for a few 100 years, but it didn't last. Some sort of natural disaster rendered it uninhabitable.
Okay, so the descendants of Far Zenith escaped a dying planet, and now they want to claim Earth for themselves?
Not their descendants.
What?
Not their descendants, it's them. The same ones who left Earth 1,000 years ago. You didn't know?
How can they still be alive? They don't even look... What did they do to themselves?
I believe it's a combination of pharmaceutical cellular treatments and technological implants.
And you? Does that mean that you're...
I'm not like them. I was made. On the way to Earth. On the ship. I spent years studying in my training interface. So that I could serve my function.
Access and control of the terraforming system. But why? What do the Zeniths want with it?
When I discovered the Zero Dawn system had disseminated into its subcomponents, I thought my purpose was to fix it. But I don't think the Zeniths want that at all. I think they want to wipe Earth clean and start over.
So the Zeniths want to exterminate life on Earth. That's what Gaia and I concluded too. But why? Why kill everyone just to take over?
When they took me on missions with them, I saw how they butchered the tribal people we encountered. They didn't seem to care about a rejuvenated Earth, so I concluded that they must want a hard reboot of the system. Then they can redesign it to be exactly what they want.
Mass extinction for their own comfort? Who thinks like that? Well, without their Gaia Colonel, they'll have a hard time doing that. The Zeniths needed Elizabeth's gene print to access Zero Dawn facilities. So they made you. Trained you. And you went along with it?
They told me I was born to interface with the Zero Dawn system. When we reached Earth, I pieced together what must have happened to Gaia and her subordinate functions. That's when I started to realize I wasn't meant to fix Gaia. That they must have made me so I could do what their remote extinction signal failed to do. Reboot Earth for their own benefit.
So you know about the extinction signal?
It was speculation, but the only logical conclusion why Gaia suddenly self-destructed after operating efficiently for centuries. Gaia would have only undertaken such a desperate course of action if it had detected a threat to life on Earth that was more dangerous than ceasing function altogether. I should have realized that she would also order the recreation of Elizabeth Sobek to rebuild her. Yeah, well, surprise.
So we're dealing with the same Far Zenith people who once lived on Earth. What else do you know about them?
They were some of the most affluent and powerful people on Earth. They controlled almost every major resource, every industry. Gerard commands them. He's the one who decided to set up a base. The others, Eric, Tilda, Verbena, they resent his authority over them, but in the end, they always do what he says.
Eric, he's the one I fought back in the Hades Proving Lab.
He enjoys hurting people.
Yeah, I know. You mentioned the Zenith set up a base here on Earth. Where is it?
Off the coast, I think. Whenever I had to go on missions, I was transported inside of a Spectre drone. I couldn't see anything outside. But I did overhear the Zeniths talking about it once. They were discussing setting up a perimeter energy shield to repel the local fauna. I'm certain they have other security measures. Spectre patrols, machine lures, it must be impregnable.
What's inside the base?
Launch facilities, so they can shuttle back and forth to their ship in orbit. Plus, infrastructure to gather materials and fabricate anything they need.
Are there more Zeniths than the ones you met?
I'm not sure. I suppose there must be more of them in the base or back on the ship. For all I know, there could be more of them out in space, other survivors of the colony.
You said the Zenith's colony in the Sirius system was destroyed. What happened?
All I was ever told was that a natural disaster forced them to leave Sirius. I've speculated that it was an extrasolar object or a cataclysmic seismic event. Or maybe even an abnormally violent coronal mass ejection from Sirius A.
The Zeniths never told you any details.
They said the only thing that mattered was that they survived. First Earth, 1,000 years ago, and then Sirius.
Guess they survived old age, too. How did you escape the Zeniths?
Before the Hades Proving Lab, I never thought I'd get away from them. Even if I were to run, I'd never survive on my own in the wilds. But then I saw you. And I thought that maybe you could help me. So when the Zeniths pinpointed Aluthia's location in the biomedical research facility, I saw an opportunity.
You said you saw an opportunity to escape when you went to capture Aluthia. What did you do, exactly?
Whenever I was taken out on a mission to recover a subordinate function, only one of the Zeniths would go with me.
The one the rebels killed, outside the facility.
Verbena's dead? How did they bypass her shield?
I'm looking into it. But you were talking about your escape?
Well, when it was time to use the Zenith's transmitter to send Aluthia back to base, I also sent the encrypted transmission. Then I distracted Verbena long enough to seal myself in the ectogenic chamber, altering the facility's log so it appeared that there were only 236 containers.
And the Gaia root kernel?
I told them I could capture Aluthia faster if I had it with me, and they believed me.
Well done. You said you were born on the way to Earth. In an artificial womb, I'm guessing?
The Zeniths had an ectogenic chamber aboard the ship. An updated version of the one you found me in. They must have used a stored sample of Elizabeth's DNA.
I doubt Elizabeth would have let them take her DNA. Do you know how they got it?
That wasn't part of the archive I was allowed to access.
You said you spent years studying in a training interface. Was this archive you mentioned part of that?
But only the parts I was permitted to access. Aristotle and Aspasia, the avatars of the archive, would assign me learning modules and evaluate my progress.
Wait, those names. They were designed to be the virtual guides for the Apollo database, before Ted Farrow purged it.
The Zeniths have a copy.
So it still exists.
got to learn from it. Only what was deemed pertinent to the mission. If I requested information outside of my parameters, my tutors would deny it. To have all that knowledge just out of reach must have been frustrating. All right, I think that's enough for now. Do you want to come upstairs, or...
So how long? You know, your plan. How long before Gaius fabricated a machine army to defeat the Xenus?
How did you know?
Optimal strategy, so?
Well, I still have to get two more subordinate functions before Gaius is powerful enough to absorb Hephaestus.
What? You don't have Hephaestus already?
Gaius is still figuring out how to capture it. It's not confined to a single...
To a single location, of course not! You didn't even know who the Xenus really are. You were supposed to be further along by now! Coming here was a mistake. They're gonna find me. They're gonna find this place and take me back. This was all for nothing.
They're not going to find us. Gaia's using Minerva to mask our location.
What difference does it make? You're too far behind. We're never going to beat them. Everything. Everyone. They're gonna die.
Hey. Calm down. You're here now, right? So is there anything you can do to help?
I have certain knowledge sets. And given your state of progress, expertise you probably lack. Geoengineering, of course. Computer science, physics, biology, chemistry.
Okay. Well, see if you can do something with that. Talk to Gaia. I'll check on you later.
How'd it go?
Her injury's not that bad, but I think she regrets coming here. Feeling might be mutual.
I'll come back later and talk to her. See if I can learn anything.
I should get the weapon fragment to Gaia.
Is it me, or did the old ones just look funny?
Funny how?
Yeah, their clothes, they're weird. They're so tight.
For once, I'd have to agree. I'd rip those things to shreds in a fight.
Guess they didn't move around as much.
One of Studius Fuadis's many scrolls. It's a pain getting him to paralyze. Still, he didn't deserve to be run down by Regala's riders. This must be from the Cool Route. Between the Rockbreaker and the Slitherfang, Regala really wrecked the arena. And I have a feeling she won't stop trying until Hikaru's dead.
Ha!
Is this a piece from the Bulwark? Catalo must have brought this with him as a trophy. I may have fired the cannon, but... he really put Dakota in his place. Hey, you and Darren okay?
Nothing some rest can't take care of. Are you okay? This beta thing, it's a lot. Even for you.
Just trying to take it one step at a time.
Fair enough. If you need anything, just let me know.
It's good to see you and Zoe enjoying yourselves.
We're learning a lot. I've actually been looking through the data to find ideas for a gift. And to thank her for helping me study the glyphs. Something from the old world that she's never seen before. Instead, I found out they gave each other stuffed animals. If you ask me, stuffing a dead animal with anything, really, doesn't sound like a good time for anybody.
Maybe Gaia can help you find something else. How's everyone dealing with Beta?
I tried explaining what a clone is to Aaron. He was totally lost. Then Zoe said something about two trees coming from one seed. That seemed to help a bit.
I see everyone settling in.
Zoe's planning on bringing all kinds of plants in here. Says a home should always spring with life anew. I asked Aaron to help find some. I think he'd rather stick his head into a snap maw.
Still, it's not a bad idea. Should liven up the place.
I should get back to the wilds.
I'll keep an eye on Beta. Make sure she's comfortable.
Okay. Looks like some of the holograms are working now.
I have repurposed the displays to track Regala's activity in the region.
A useful war map.
I hope I'm not interrupting.
No, but I must ask. The woman Varl and Aaron brought in, she's related to you.
It's hard to explain. She's more of a copy.
Good. If she's anything like you, we've just gained reinforcements.
Maybe. Why did Takote think you wouldn't be a threat to him if- You said you were training with the Focus?
That's right. I've been watching holograms of your first fight with the Zenith Spectres. They are faster and more agile than any machines I've faced before. How many did the Zeniths have?
I'm not sure. Probably a lot.
I would not wish to face them en masse.
I'm with you there. Getting Aether out of the Grove made for quite a spectacle.
One that showed the entire tribe that Hikaru's mission for peace is the correct path, for it is now blessed by the Ten themselves.
I heard my friend Talana came by the base. Did you get a chance to meet her?
Briefly. A bold woman going into T'Nakth territory with that Karja armor of hers. She'll be lucky if my people don't shoot her on sight.
She'll be careful. She's just looking for someone who might need her help.
Whoever it is, they better be worth dying for.
Have you had a chance to speak with Varl?
Briefly. He fought well against Regala's troops at Baron Light. Are all Nora as skilled as the two of you?
I'm not exactly one of them. But anyway, the Nora can hold their own. They managed to push the Karja from their lands.
I thought my tribe was the only one to have done that. Impressive.
I need to go.
On your way, then.
So now we know the origin of the transmission.
Yeah. I also recovered this. The weapon it was part of somehow stripped a Zenith of its shield, but it malfunctioned and blew up. If we can recreate the weapon and improve it, maybe we'll gain the upper hand on the Zeniths.
A moment. I will scan it. Complete. By combining the results with data from your Focus, I can infer that the weapon was highly advanced, comparable to Zenith technology. But not how it worked.
Did the explosion corrupt the data?
It was only a catalyst. The moment the weapon malfunctioned, it appears a command executed to purge all data within its core. Ostensibly, this was to prevent the weapon's secrets from falling into enemy hands. Whoever designed this weapon knew how to cover their tracks.
Silence.
Based on your data on him, that is my conclusion as well.
And he's not gonna cooperate with us. Well, it was worth a shot. But that's not all. The Zeniths got Aluthia, along with Artemis and Apollo.
That is unfortunate. However, our original plan remains unchanged. The two remaining subordinate functions should increase my heuristic processing density enough to absorb Hephaestus.
Right. One problem at a time. Well, I guess I better get back out there.
I wish you luck on your search.
Right. Thanks, Gaia. So I guess we won't be making use of Cylon's weapon. And now there is another clone of Elizabeth here with us. But I can't let it distract me. I still have two more sub-functions to get. Hey, Gaia. I'm back.
So I see what is on your mind.
So, I guess Beta's here to stay. I gave her a focus. Told her to talk to you to see if she can help. She's not what I expected.
What were you expecting?
I don't know. Someone more helpful, I guess. And less pessimistic.
It is true, she overestimated our progress. However, it is also worth noting that her confidence in your abilities emboldened her to escape the Zeniths.
I guess so.
Give her time. She may yet come around.
When we were at the facility where we found Beta, there were records that said Far Zenith were researching embryogenesis. I know they traded their ectogenic chambers to Zero Dawn, but why were they researching it in the first place?
At this point, we can only speculate. Perhaps at one time they meant the Odyssey to be a colony ship, necessitating such technology. As their goals evolved over time, so did their areas of research.
So they got more selfish as the risks of staying on Earth kept rising. So the Zeniths are the same people who left Earth. Physically immortal. How'd they figure it out?
From what we know of Far Zenith, it is plausible that prominent geneticists and engineers were offered a place aboard the Odyssey in exchange for their expertise. Given enough time, technology, and resources, any challenge can be overcome.
Like how Minerva eventually generated the deactivation codes for the Pharaoh Plague.
Exactly.
I guess I should get going.
As you say. Be well, Aloy.